Have you ever wondered if someone could be secretly reading your online messages or stealing your passwords right now, without you even knowing? In today's video, we're going to uncover a powerful hacking technique that could be happening on your network at this very moment. Stay tuned until the end to learn how to protect yourself from this invisible threat. Welcome back to Tech Guy's Ethical Hacking 2024 playlist. I'm your host, Brandon, and today we're diving deep into the world of ARP spoofing attacks. This technique is a favorite among hackers because it's relatively simple to execute but can have devastating consequences. But don't worry, by the end of this video, you'll not only understand how these attacks work, but you'll also know how to defend against them. Let's start by understanding what ARP spoofing is all about. ARP, or Address Resolution Protocol, is like the phone book of your local network. It's responsible for mapping IP addresses to physical MAC addresses. When a device wants to communicate with another on the same network, it uses ARP to figure out which physical device corresponds to a particular IP address. Now, imagine if someone could manipulate this phone book, redirecting all your calls to them instead of the intended recipient. That's essentially what ARP spoofing does, but with network traffic instead of phone calls. To demonstrate this attack, we're going to need two machines, a Windows PC as our target and a Kali Linux system as our attacker. Let's start with our Windows machine. First, we need to gather some information about our network. On the Windows PC, open up PowerShell. You can do this by right-clicking the Start menu and selecting Windows PowerShell. Once it's open, type in the following command, ARP A. This command displays the ARP cache, which shows us the current IP to MAC address mappings known to this machine. Look for the first entry that has an IP address ending in 0.62. This is our router. Make a note of both its IP address and MAC address. And all of the above is the IP address of our Windows machine. Both of these will be used in the attack. In this example, 192.168.233.62 is the router's IP address, and next is its MAC address. Your specific addresses will be different, so make sure to use the ones you see on your screen. Now that we have our target information, let's switch over to our Kali Linux machine. This is where the magic happens. Open up a terminal and run this command, sudo su. Enter your password when prompted. You should now see a symbol at the start of your command line, indicating you have root access. Next, we need to install a package called dsniff, which contains the ARP spoof tool we'll be using. Run this command, apt install dsniff. If it asks for confirmation, type Y and press Enter. Now dsniff is installed. We need to find out our IP address on the Kali machine. Open up a terminal and run these two commands, hostname I. This will show you the IP address of your Kali machine. Make a note of it. Next, run ipRouteGrepDefault. This command will show you the default gateway, which is typically your router's IP address. It's good to double-check this against the information we got from the Windows machine. Now that we have all our network information, it's time to set up for the attack. In the Kali terminal. Now we're ready to launch our ARP spoofing attack. We're going to run two separate ARP spoof commands, each in its own terminal window. These commands will trick both the router and the target Windows machine into sending their traffic through our Kali machine. In your current terminal, run this command, ARP spoof, where I represents the network interface, which is WLAN0, and T represents the target IP address. In our case, it is the IP address of our Windows machine, which is 192.168.233.105. Then next is the IP address of our router, which is 192.168.233.62. Replace 192.168.233.105 with the IP address of your Windows target, and 192.168.233.62 with your router's IP address. This command tells the router that we are the Windows machine. Now, open a new terminal window. You can do this by pressing Ctrl+Shift+T, gain root privileges again with sudo su, and run this second command, ARP spoof, where I represents the network interface, which is WLAN0, and T represents the target IP address. In our case, it is the IP address of our router, which is 192.168.233.62. Then next is the IP address of our Windows machine, which is 192.168.233.105. This time, we're telling the Windows machine that we are the router. With these two commands running, we've effectively placed ourselves in the middle of the connection between the Windows machine and the router. Any traffic between them will now flow through our Kali machine. But we're not done yet. By default, Linux will drop packets that aren't meant for it. To make sure the network still functions and to avoid suspicion, we need to enable IP forwarding. In a new terminal window, run echo1proc sysnet ipv4ip_forward. This command tells Linux to forward any packets it receives that aren't meant for it, allowing normal network traffic to continue. To verify that our attack is working, go back to the Windows machine and run a RPA again in PowerShell. You should now see that the MAC address associated with the router's IP address has changed. It should now match the MAC address of your Kali Linux machine. Congratulations. You've successfully executed an ARP spoofing attack. At this point, all traffic between the Windows machine and the router is passing through your Kali Linux system. In a real-world scenario, an attacker could now use tools to inspect this traffic, potentially capturing sensitive information like passwords or credit card numbers. But remember, with great power comes great responsibility. As ethical hackers, our goal is to understand these techniques so we can better defend against them. So, how can you protect yourself and your network from ARP spoofing attacks? First, use static ARP entries for critical devices. This prevents them from accepting spoofed ARP responses. Second, implement VLANs to segment your network, limiting the scope of potential attacks. Third, use ARP spoofing detection tools, which can alert you to suspicious ARP activity on your network. Additionally, enable security features on your network switches if available. Many modern switches have built-in protections against ARP spoofing. Always use encryption protocols like HTTPS for sensitive data. Even if an attacker intercepts your traffic, they won't be able to read it. Finally, regularly monitor your network traffic for unusual patterns that might indicate an ongoing attack. In conclusion, ARP spoofing is a powerful technique that can be devastating in the wrong hands. As we've seen, it allows an attacker to silently intercept and potentially modify network traffic. But by understanding how these attacks work, we can better protect ourselves and our networks. Remember, the techniques we've discussed today should only be used in controlled, authorized environments. Unauthorized use of these methods is not only unethical but also illegal. Thank you for watching this deep dive into ARP spoofing attacks. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more content on ethical hacking and cybersecurity. Stay safe out there, and happy hacking.